RMS value of AC. RMS value of AC means root mean square value of alternating current. Okay. The term RMS refers to time varying sinusoidal currents and voltage. That is, current and voltage are changing with respect to what? Time. Okay. So how to define the root mean square value of alternating current? It is defined as square root of mean of the squares of all the currents over one cycle. We are taking the mean of squares of the current over one cycle. So it is denoted by IRMS, and the corresponding voltage is denoted by VRMS. Okay, current is denoted by IRMS, voltage is denoted by VRMS. So the alternating current is given by I is equal to Im sine omega t. Suppose omega t is equal to theta, then I is equal to Im sine theta. Okay, so this is the instantaneous value of alternating current. So this is how your current looks like. Okay, this is the value of the alternating current. The red line gives you the value of the alternating current. Now here the square is given by that blue dotted line. The square will be what? Positive value only. When you take the value of the negative current and square it, you will get a positive value. Okay, for positive also you'll get a positive value, for negative also you'll get a positive value, because we are what? Squaring it. So we have drawn a graph for I square. We have drawn a graph for what? I square. Okay. So the sum of squares of all the currents over one cycle is given by area of one cycle of the square wave. We are going to take the area of one cycle of what? Square wave. So IRMS is equal to area of one cycle of square wave by base length of one cycle. Here we are taking the full cycle. So area root of area of one cycle of square wave by base length of one cycle of square wave. So here we are going to consider the elementary thickness. We are going to take in the square wave, we are going to take what? A small element. The thickness is d theta. The thickness is what? D theta. Okay. So let I square by the mid ordinate of the element. So we are taking the mid ordinate as what? I square. So what is the area of the element? I square into d theta. I square into what? D theta. So we have found out the area for the small element. Now we have to calculate the area for the full square wave. So here we are going to take the full square wave. So full square means what? 0 to 2 pi. We are not taking half cycle. We are taking full cycle. So 0 to 2 pi. I square d theta. So what is the value of I? I is equal to Im sine theta. The whole square is Im square sine square theta d theta. Okay, taking Im square outside, integral 0 to 2 pi sin square theta d theta. Okay, now sin square theta can be written as 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2. This is the trigonometrical formula. Sin square theta can be written as 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2. Substituting for sin 2 theta, sin square theta, 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2. Okay. Taking the 2 outside the integration, Im square by 2, multiply 1 into d theta is d theta. So separating the integrals, integral 0 to 2 pi d theta minus integral 0 to 2 pi cos 2 theta d theta. Okay. Now what is integral of d theta? Integral of d theta is theta. Integral of cos 2 theta is sin 2 theta by 2. Integral of cos 2 theta is what? Sin 2 theta is 2. For both the integrals, the limit is same. So 0 to 2 pi. Substituting the limits. Im square by 2. Okay. 2 pi. If you put the zero, it's zero only. 2 pi. For theta, I'm substituting as 2 pi minus sine 2 into, for theta, I'm substituting as 2 pi by 2. Okay. Minus 0 minus sine 0 by 2. First, we are substituting the limits for 2 pi. Then we are substituting the limits for 0. Okay. So here, sine 0 is 0 and sine 4 pi is also what? 0. Sine n pi is 0. Okay. So sine 0 is 0. Sine 4 pi is also what? 0. So what will you get here is this term will become 0. This whole term will become 0. So you'll be getting only 2 pi. So Im square by 2 into 2 pi. So 2 and 2 will get cancelled. So we are getting at Im square pi. So this is the area of a square wave in one full cycle. Area of the square wave in one full cycle. Now what is IRMS? IRMS is root of area of one cycle of square wave by base length of one cycle. What is the base length of one cycle? Base length of one cycle is 2 pi. So we have taken the full cycle. So this is 2 pi. Okay. So what is the area of one cycle of a square wave? Im square pi. Just now we calculated. So IRMS is equal to root of Im square pi by 2 pi according to this formula. So what you are getting? Im by root 2. So IRMS value is pi and pi will get cancelled. You are getting Im by root 2. That is peak value by root 2. Then what is IRMS? 1 by root 2 is 0.707. So IRMS is equal to 0.707 Im. So the IMS, IRMS value is 0.707 Im. So this is the value of IRMS. Or if you write it in percentage, it is 70.7% of peak value. The RMS value is of current is 70.7% of peak value. Okay. Suppose if you want to write the alternating voltage in similar way, then we can write VRMS is equal to 0.707 Vm. VRMS is 70.7 times the peak value of alternating voltage. Okay. Another way of defining the alternating current, the value of alternating current is also called as the effective value. It is also called as what? Effective value. So this is used to compare with that of the steady current. Okay. RMS value of current of AC to an equivalent steady current. That is a DC current. How we can compare it with that of a DC current? So we can define the RMS value as the value of steady current, which when flowing through a given circuit for a given time, produces the same amount of heat as produced by the alternating current when flowing through the same circuit for the same time. So you take a DC current and allowing it to flow through a circuit which is having resistance for a given time. So according to Joule's heating effect, it will produce heat. The same heat should be produced when you are passing the alternating current through the same circuit for the same time. So there is a comparison between the DC current and the AC current. Okay. The heat produced by the DC current through the same circuit for the same time should be equivalent to that of the heat produced by the alternating current through the same circuit for the same time. So this is how the RMS value is also defined. This is another definition of what? RMS value of AC. So the effective value of alternating voltage is represented by V effective. It can also be called as what? V effective. Okay.